capital deductions. What that means is that you may have a billion in terms of capital, but only in general insurance, 84% is recognized as capital. So what that means is that now you have deductions in general insurance, you have 16% of it being deducted, and in life about 14%. So this just means that the actuarial team and the finance team should really work together, the boards and the shareholders, to try and restructure those balance sheet, because I don't see why you should have capital deductions at all if when you're applying this market. I see general insurance say we don't have currency risk, we don't have bonds, you know, we're not investing in USD, but there's a big currency risk that they don't look at. Also, in medical insurance, which takes about 30% of the market, most of the drugs in the country are imported. We look at 60% of drugs are imported. So that means that the moment the currency jumps, like when it did 2 years ago, when it moved from 85 shillings to the dollar to 110, that's a 20% jump in the currency risk. That means your claims will jump by 20%. And if your combined ratio is only giving you a fat of 5%, you'll not be able to make money.
But the number of people who are actually in the pension system is a very small number. It's only like 200,000. And it's not really that people are shying away from that. There are very many factors around that. First of all, the level of disposable income is not too much. So people do not have sufficient money to save. Then you also have another problem, which is that people don't actually understand issues around retirement funding and pensions. And then we still have a fairly strong support system whereby if you actually don't have a pension, you may be helped by part of your family. But as that starts to erode, you'll start to see the pension side growing much bigger.
In partnership with IRA, we've noticed that the impact is that the solvency levels have dropped from 400% to 130%. What that means is that if you had a capital of 400 million, now all of a sudden you're being asked to put in more capital. So that is the key impact, and the key reasons for it is one, credit risk, which is coming about by people not paying premiums on time, so the insurer is being asked to put in more capital. The second layer is on the investments that they're putting in, so things like property, equity. So the new requirements are that the insurer should be ready to pay for claims when they're required to do that.
When I took over the leadership of the organization I lead, we had about $60 million of assets under management. Today it's in excess of $2 billion. In that period, and it's largely invested in East Africa in a number of sectors. We're seeing opportunities arising out of urbanization, the fact that there's need for cities and cities that are well organized and new urban nodes, and that's what we began when we put up Two Rivers, which is an urban node. We're doing something similar at the coast. We're seeing, and it's not just us, it's a trend that, you know, that is emerging, and which tells you that there's opportunity, there's deep underlying demand. Our story many times is told by observers who are looking at us. We are not doing enough within our professional bodies to tell our story as the people living in this environment. And to be able to address and speak to a sophisticated audience in other parts of the world. When I engage with international investors, institutional international investors, on the other side of the table, I am speaking with a risk director of a fund who is an actuary. But their reference when looking at our market is a story that is written by somebody who does not have the training. And sometimes the way the story has been told, that's what they have to believe. And so I believe we have a role to play in telling our story.
Actuaries face the challenge of changing their focus to one that is less concerned with the analysis of data, but more focused on the insights to be gained from that data. We will be adding value from the visualization of that data, advising on meaningful interventions and solutions based on those insights. Actuaries understand connectivity, and our role will be to communicate meaning and impact of the risks and trends that we identify. But who can say what comes next? From today's personal computers to tomorrow's personalized robots? Perhaps. Professions are becoming more affordable. People are becoming increasingly connected and capable, able to crowdsource their own solutions. Problems are being decomposed into their constituent elements, which can then be standardized, systemized, and dealt with by machines, rather than handled in a bespoke fashion by expensive experts. Whichever way the future plays itself out, actuaries will need to embrace change and to evolve as the external environment does. Innovation continues to shift many of our ways of working, and to dismiss these technologies and the way that they will change our realities would be a mistake. According to Ericsson, by 2019, there will be 930 million mobile phones in Africa. Almost one, for every person on the continent. And that's quite staggering. Innovations such as these are now paying dividends locally. Technology is fueling growth, which is evident in the expansion of infrastructure.